Did you try? Did you ever try to talk him to step down for you to go on a board?
No, I've never done that. And this is a political, I mean, this is a democratic dispensation. Everybody has his or her own agenda, even though we say politics is about negotiation. But I never talk him out of the contest because, one, I know there was no way he was going to beat me in this contest. There was no, absolutely no way. I would have been surprised if he got about 30% of the vote. But I don't know. But that's what God has planned for us, and that is what we are witnessing today. I am very much saddened. When I came to Ashama first, my brother was teaching in the mother school. I lived with my brother in that school. And one of his brothers has a house at Bethlehem. I lived in that house, so I'm more or less like a family member. So when we met on the political terrain too, we share jokes, we crack our jokes. One of his first cousins, they have a name that they call Keseorovu, and that I have inherited that name. And anytime I see him, I call him by that name, Keseorovu, and then we all laugh, and then we go ahead. So we lost a comrade, a gem, somebody who has a vision for the Ashama municipality, somebody who has a vision for the NDC fraternity, and somebody who wished to see his people, flourish in their businesses, etc. We lost a gem, but God knows best. We are here today to mourn him. We can only give thanks to the Almighty God for what he has done for us.
Right. I hope you have definitely heard controversies. People will say, hey, MP now just on Pesel Obeba, and you know, he might even know something about that. The rumor is out there. How do you take such rumor and how do you address it?
Well, I take it in good faith. Under normal circumstances, if it had happened on me, if I were the one today that we are mourning, my supporters, my followers would have said the same thing. Probably I might have died with my natural death, but people will see go. To say about this thing. So it's a fair comment anybody could have made, but that is not at its place. We are seeing things we are seeing things in a normal situation, but we don't know what God has planned. People might have attacked me that I have killed Maswest, but I can swear by the Bible, I have no hand in it. And I don't know any shrine. Ever since I started politics, I've never gone to any place for any. I look up to the Almighty God. So, but it's a fair comment. I can only urge my supporters, the party members, that they shouldn't do this to escalate, to extreme, that our opponent will take advantage of it. No matter what it is, we are all the same family. Unfortunately, we have lost one of our own, so we should just take it cool. And my supporters should not encounter anybody who might have said one way or the other that Ernest Nogbe was the one who killed Maswell. They should remain calm. Whatever anybody will say, it is God Almighty who is the ultimate judge. No human being can judge us. And as I am here today, I look up to God in this matter. So God should speak in this matter, whether it is Ernest Nogbe who has a hand in the death of my competitor. It is up to God to do his bid, and nobody can judge apart from God. So my supporters should remain calm. Anybody can say anything, they should take it in good faith. And let's all continue to pray for NDC. Let's all continue to pray for Ashama. As I speak with you, we have lost about 5 chairmen at a go, 5 branch chairmen at a go. We should continue to pray for NDC because our population is dwindling. People who work for the party to come to power in 2020, they are going. So we need to pray unceasingly for the party so that at the end of the day, we will get the number of people who campaign for the party to win 2020 election.
But have you been physically attacked because of this issue?
No, nobody has physically attacked me. And I've never heard anybody one-on-one pointing fingers at me. The rumors is in town, but nobody has spoken to me on it. The family has been consistent ever since the issue occurred. The family has been consistent by telling everybody that they know what killed their children. So nobody should point accusing fingers to anybody. So I share in their vision, so I also remain calm, and nobody has attacked me on any way, even verbally or physically, nobody has.
Honorable, thank you very much, and our condolences to you.
Thank you.